but we are going to be working on the sheet that covers armor, ammunition, and weapons. Because that needs to be done, and I need to move basically everything I've done over to this system. I have simplified this a lot! It is so much simpler to work with for basically everyone. Previously you had like 50 of these to fill out. Now they're down to 20? Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23. Okay, fine, 23, but still, it's better than 50. And you don't actually have to fill out all of them, because it depends on the item you're making. If you're making ammunition, for instance, you only need to fill out one damage type instead of like four. So a lot of these, or most of these, won't actually be necessary to fill out, depending on the item you're creating. What's left is to make the actual code to make this work, because I haven't done that yet. And that's what we're gonna do today. But what I'm gonna do first is make a new sheet. So this is going to be a long sword. And it is a melee weapon. Skill. Let's do this properly. Let's find the long sword skill. And put that in. Long sword. No, that's not the long sword. It's 1.5. Half. 1.5 hand weapons. That's the one. We're gonna see if this works, because that's only a theory. Ow! Back. It's rare. Fine, I'm gonna do this properly. Toblin, we meet again. Indeed we do, Delian. Hello? This is not where I wanted to go. Where's the trade article, my brah? Ah, I see. Long sword. Oh, shit.
Rank up. Hold the line. This happened.
There are the dinosaurs. Welcome, people. Make yourself at home and enjoy the show. So, Actually, I should have that somewhere, don't I? Haha! U22. Which group? 11. Okay, cool. Trader U22. Raiders of the Lost Park. That is still such a bad and awesome pun, both at the same time. I can see a problem here. Let me see if I can fix that.
Just pulling the CD10.
Let's do that. Now you can actually see the thing. This is really backwards, because to me, the code sheet is on the right side of my monitor, but for you, it's on the left side. I am confused. Anyway, the price was, no, trade group, group 11. Wow. I don't know what it weighs. I have to shake it up. Zinc I have. Longsword. It's about 1.1, 1.2 kilos, but what did I write? 4 pounds. Why do I have values in pounds? Oh, because, never mind. 4 pounds. Let's just steal the description straight off. Like so. And then I finished two more of my Pekala cultures last week. Now I only got three more to go. Why not have both Imperial and Metric? Because I have neither. The pounds here is not the liberal bottom stock. LBS, not pounds. It is Skålpund, which is an old sort of Viking age until middle medieval Swedish measurement. So it's not actually pounds, it's pund. That's why. It's the internal measuring system of Dark Shadows. But maybe I should have that as kilos, I don't know. We'll see. Maybe I'll do that someday. For now, we're just gonna test and we're gonna get the code working and then we can wonder about such things. Slash Pierce Bludgeoning. Slash four bludgeoning. Three. No. Four, three, one, three. Okay. Four, three, one. No energy damage. Three. Oops. Three. Yeah, sure, okay. Parry value. Four. There we go. Welcome to yawning. Reach is long. Doesn't have range because it's not a ranged weapon. Doesn't have a magazine, no accuracy, no rate of fire, no charge, no armor areas. There you go. Melee. Medieval. Historical. Sword. Long sword. Folder. I should create folders eventually. Do you have pommels as throwing weapons? Skallagrim would be proud of you. End him rightly. Now, I need this block. That's why I made it, because I need to have it here so I can see, see what it looks like. Oh my god. Right, that's why. Okay, cool. Now we're going to have to do the whole damage thing. Because, as we can see here, no stats are included here. Which is a bit of a problem. So, we're going to do that right now. And that will be this one. I hear strange noises. Anyway. Where do we start? Did it list quality? No. It doesn't list quality because I didn't change quality from normal. Okay, cool. So it's not listed. Okay. This section will be available regardless of the item type. I don't need a condition down here. I believe it should be here. But, if I just do that, we're just gonna have another column on the end. We have to make a new row. So technically it should be here. after that one. Div class row. I forgot how to do this entire thing, so I'm just gonna do it the classical way. Div class row. Row. Pathetic Battle wants to know when the PDF is coming out, but is not being serious. You asking on the CD10 server? Because I'm not watching that at the moment. But probably not too long from now. It is kind of my goal to get a basic PDF out. And by basic, I mean real basic. No art, no fancy formatting, just here's the system, you can play it. Relatively soonish. And by relatively soonish, in my terms, could mean anything from a week to 3 months. Probably. I'm not good at this. Okay, now we're gonna have how did this work again? Let me check something. Because I have a tool for this to make this a lot easier for me, but I have to check how it works. Because I have forgotten everything about it. There it is. Packages. What is installed? I do not remember the name of the thing that I want to use to simplify my life. Because I haven't used this code editor in 4 freaking ever. I seem to remember it being control space as the shortcut, but I'm not sure. No. Shit. It's not this one, is it? It is this one. Damn it, it is this one. Okay. It was control E. Okay. You were supposed to be able to do like 3. Let's see. Emmet Atom. How did you do this? I do not remember. Yes, yes. Atom emit add multiple classes. Oh god, no. Abbreviation syntax. There, this was the what I was looking for. Yeah. Okay, there we go. So, what I want is div class goal 12. No, that's not what we're. I do this then. Ah, okay. Not as useful as I thought, but anyway, it works.
Meep.
I need to be here and here. Okay, so my plan is for this thing to be two-parter on both parts. And I know that doesn't make sense, but what I mean is the damage stats and everything should be here, and the rest of the stats should be here. So it's gonna be like a four-box thing. That's my thought right now, anyway. So what I need now is a class, div class, what are we kind of call it? Block weapon stats. No, block lethality. Block lethality box. That's what we're gonna call it. Yep. That's very descriptive. That's gonna be that one. And we're gonna have to add that one to the CSS. And it's gonna float left, so it's gonna be the partner of this. So this all gets added exactly as it is to this. And then we're gonna have the lethality info box, which is then going to be this. Please indent. There we go. Lethality info box, which is going to be on the right of this, which is then blah, 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 lethality info box. Yes. And then there we go. Blep. I mean, I know they're empty, but I should at least have gotten the borders. Oh, I didn't put in the... I forgot to put it in the... Words are hard. I forgot... Let's try that again. I forgot to put in the CSS. There we go. Seven words. Or eight, maybe. Hard to string them together. That should do it. Correct. They look like ass. But correct. I need to have a break in between them and the no wait, no 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 no. We're gonna have a margin right here. Margin top 20 pixels. That should take care of that. That's kind of correct. And of course, they are almost matched up here, but they're not quite. So, there's something iffy going on here. And I do believe I think I know what that is. I'm always looking forward to more of your space adventure thing with Guy on his channel. I haven't been so hooked on an RPG show in ages. I am glad to hear it. We had a lot of fun doing it too. So, very glad to hear. So if I remove this, is everything just going to massively and magically explode? Which I think it is. But, you know, we have to today. Please no explodey. No, that makes them line up. But it also makes them not respect the margin. But that's fine, kinda. But that also means I need to fix these. And that. We'll do that later. For now, let's focus on this. I am going to be entirely honest and say that I felt that I was just flailing wildly in that entire series. I had no idea how to play my character, so she really just... I had a few things about her written down, but it was like I didn't know how she was going to behave at all. So that was truly a kind of a blind role-playing thing. But it was fun to try that for once. And watching the episodes now afterwards, I don't actually... I mean, when I played it, I felt that I was really a lot in the background and I didn't really stick out or make a name for myself, or my character didn't have much of a personality. But watching it afterwards, it's like, it wasn't that bad, actually. Which was fun. How can I fix that, though?
Because that's a problem.
You just make the padding larger? Okay, let's not mess with that. Let's get the code in place before I get distracted again. So, this is going to contain 8 boxes. No. 10 boxes. How do I do this in the best way possible? Okay, let's just start with... if variables... What did I call the variables again? I need to look. Shit. I did not mean to do that. Please go away. Delete shit. Yes. Ah. slash pierce blunt energy shock. If variables slash is not empty, variables slash. And if I'm just going to do this, slash pierce blunt energy shock, pierce blunt energy shock. And then here we're gonna have, oh shit. Oh, hey, thank you, Danny, and welcome to the stream. I hope you enjoy your stray among the cult. Yes, that's exactly what I wanted to say. That's how English works. Bleh. Berry. Variables, berry.
Berry.
And then we need a reach. Harry should probably not be first, to be honest, but whatever. So we should have reach or range. Actually, no. English does sound something like that. Well, that's good. Reach, range. I simplified the range rules, didn't I? I'm fairly sure I did. So let's have a look. Advanced. Why is caps lock in? Okay, ranged. There. Yes, I did simplify this. It doesn't need to be listed. Just need the range values. Cool. Eep. Eep, 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 eep. Reach, range. Parry, mag. Mag. Bleh. Bleh. Stop. Oh god, I am screwing up so bad. Mag. Auto-ack. And finally, rough. Right. Mag, that should probably be there. Charge. Charge. And if the armor, if the item is an armor, you're probably very interested in what areas it covers. So that's going to be at the top. Armor areas. Armor areas. There. Now, if we just throw this into the thing, we should get the values displaying in the most ugly way possible, which is just raw text. Just wrote an article with whipped cream. That sounds awesome. Oh, right. If variables type I'm gonna need my old sheet here. And I now see I've thrown it away. Oh, great. Awesome. Fantastic. Okay. Beep. This is gonna be a problem. No, not this one. This one. Cheat some locks. Item templates. This code is going to give me nightmares, but I'll have to look at it. Language is Twig with HTML. Oh boy. Okay. If variables type equals I would like to have a wild card here. But I don't think that Twig supports regular expressions. If I'm to be honest. Does it? Twig if wild card. Twig does support regular expressions. What? Okay, that's cool. Now I just have to remember how the damn thing works. What was the option here? Flexible armor, soft armor, hard armor. So if it contains armor with a capital A, it should work. Alright, cool. If variables type what was the word again? It's not equals, it's contains. And Twig regex contain. I'm just gonna make sure I'm not breaking anything here. Okay, if variables type matches that I'm not sure that's gonna work, but we'll try. That's Twig to the right? Yes, that is indeed Twig. I'm working on stat blocks today. And this might explode hilariously, which it's very likely that the oh shit, what? That's gonna be closed immediately. This is gonna explode now. It did not. What? Are you kidding me? Didn't it? What? Oh, because I didn't actually get it to paste in. Save changes. I think I accidentally deleted my old item block. No, I didn't. And it doesn't matter because it's available here, so that's okay. Alright, save changes and test. How is this not broken? How is this working? What? Okay, fine. If I change this to type flexible armor. No, wait. Stop. It doesn't show head anymore. It worked. It goddamn worked. That's so neat. Okay. Armor areas. Let's take chest and abdomen. Because it doesn't show at all now. Now it does. It freaking works. I did it. Okay, that was easier than I expected. It didn't even break. And if I now change this back to a melee weapon, then this chest and abdomen should go away. Perfect. I hear you, Mises. Okay.
You're a wizard, Toblin.
Indeed I am. I kind of want to try something. And I'm not sure this is a terrible idea. But it likely is. That should change nothing, theoretically, for now. Okay, it does. Changes it to the next row. That's okay, because I'm gonna add stat title and stat value to this thing. Stat title, stat value. Beep, boop. And I'm gonna go with float left and float right. Gonna have to go through all of these and do that because it just breaks What the hell? Availability. Variables availability. There we go. Oops. And delete this. These are really long. Can we zoom out a bit so I can see what's happening? Trader. Why do you do this? Cease your shenanigans. Whatever. There we go. Okay, we still need this whole thing. A twig in... Ah. I see. That was a pun that went over my head. But I succumb, or I submit to your punniness. Then wait. Why am I doing this? Mostly just to try it out, because I kind of want to see if I can separate them on the left and right to make the block a little prettier. Hello, tardies! Not quite. Right. I need a width. With that might solve the problem. Oh. Whoops. Whoops, whoops, whoops. Ah! Did solve it. Now I just need text align right to make it look a little bit prettier. Also that needs to be updated. That actually works. But we're going to, of course, have a little bit of a gap between them. So if I do this, like border, solid, yellow. Actually, let's go with this. Cyber warning light. 2 pixels. Not sure that works if I use it in a block, but we'll see. Because the variables don't really exist. Oh, it does. Okay, cool. We also need kind of a margin. Margin. Bottom. 5 pixels. So I can see where the things are. I also need a bit of padding on that. Padding 5 pixels. Just a tiny bit of padding. I mean, I should really do this in the editor here, but I can't be arsed. Wouldn't the variable only work on that world, so the block would be borked on other worlds? Yes, correct. I'm not actually going to use the border. I'm just using it now to visualize what is happening here. So it's not that they're not going to have a border. I'm going to remove that. I just want to do it now so I can see what the hell I'm doing. Okay. Again, I should just adjust the CSS here, but lazy. Okay, we're gonna have to increase the minimum height a bit. There we go. That's a bit of a margin, isn't it? Yeah, with the padding and the margin, it gets really big. I'm unsure of what happened. I go the hot pinks for testing. That could work. Hot pink could work. I'm just gonna do this. Padding left. Just so we have some padding. Padding, padding, padding. Padding, padding, padding. Right and left. And the margin should probably be shrunk a little bit. Like so. Neon green for testing. That's better. And now we can drop the minimum size back down again because it didn't get that ridiculously big. Zip. Okay, cool. What we need to do now is obviously replicate this down below. We need to steal this. and do that. Slash. I don't think we need slash damage. No, wait. This is gonna be on the left. This is just going to be boxes. This does not need to do this, because this is gonna have something else. This is gonna be damage box, and this is going to be damage value box. Damage name box. Slash, and this is going to be variables slash. Because this is going to be like, it's just going to be a bunch of boxes here. In a row, basically. Oh, hello, Thanos, welcome. I am doing fine, sir. I'm working on the blocks, thingsies. This is obviously going to be Pierce. Pierce? Brosnan? Pierce? Oh shit. Did not mean to do that. Blunt. 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 Energy. 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 I'm gonna close this again because it's messing up with my autocomplete, which is not great. Hello, Barbossa! Oh, Sparklebeard! That was a while ago. Welcome back! Haven't seen you in a while. It is good for you to come back home to the cult where you belong. Shock. And shock. This is going to be armor protected areas. Variables armor areas. Very friendly cult with cookies. Indeed. At least that's what we tell everyone else. Reach. Oops, reach. I think I'm gonna skip the colon, maybe? Not sure, we'll see. Reach. Range. I wish I could do that. Range. Range. Parry. Parry value. Parry. Parry, parry, thrust, thrust, good. Don't think we need that spacing now though. Whoops. Whoops! Fix. We do not need that spacing, we should fix that. There we go. Magazine size. Magazine. Meg. Slash. That's not supposed to be slash, that's supposed to be charge. Charge. Charge blast, I think is the word in the rules. Charge. Then we have auto-ack. Accuracy penalty. Auto-ack. And finally, rough. Which is rate of fire. Rate of fire. Scheiße. There you go. Ruff. Don't Don't. Just don't. There we go. Mr. Toblin, I have a question. I'm considering making a Call of Cthulhu RPG world set in the 1920s, and I was curious what advice you can give to TTRPG world building. Well, that's a bit generic to ask a question for. I'm not saying that the setting is generic, just that that question is kind of like, how long of a list do you want? Is it going to be Earth, for one? So it's going to be the Earth 1920, or it's just going to be sort of an alternate Earth, alternate history? There's so many questions here. okay. So, well, the main thing is, when it comes to Call of Cthulhu-esque things, do your research. What was society like in 1920? How will a Cthulhu mythos thing affect the 1920s society? So yeah, do your research first on society, technology, history, if the history is the same up to that point. What are the big political things? What is the talk of the day in the 1920s? Things like that. Research is probably your most important thing here. Okay, so damage box, damage name box, and damage value box are gonna have to be added. I'm probably just gonna copy these straight off. No, wait, that doesn't work. Because I wanna put them next to each other. Anyway, we're gonna need them, so we're gonna add them anyway. Damage, name box, and whoops, damage value box. And the only thing I know right off the bat is that they're gonna have a border, a solid white 2 pixels. With a border radius of 10 pixels. That's the only thing I know right now. It's not gonna be white, it's not gonna be solid, but that's a good start. Okay. I think actually, oh hello, a songbird. It's nice to see you. I have theory. Could I just do this? Float left with 25%, or 23%, I guess, with a margin right of like 2 pixels.
Enjoy your stay.
Oh, thank you for the follow. On a lunch break, and I figured I could stop by for a few minutes.
You're most welcome.
I don't know if this is gonna work. This is pure conjecture and testing.
I doubt this will work, but we'll see.
Maybe I surprise myself with ingeniousness. That almost worked the way I intended. Almost. I reached over 200 followers at some point recently. I did? On Twitch or on World Anvil? I am terrible at keeping track. Yeah, that's what I was afraid of. Let's try 23. The Twitch. Wow, that's impressive. Thank you for following this crazy old Scandinavian making games. Block lethality box is probably block lethality box. There it is. Is that the entire thing? It is. Okay, anyway. These are going to be centered, of course. So text align center. We need this as well. Okay, so it's really just the order that I'm lining them up here. Yeah, okay. I need to do the names first, and then the damage values. Because as they're listed now, they're just gonna go dit, which is not what I want. I want kind of the damage values on the top, or the damage names on the top and the damage values on the bottom. So these are going to have to be moved. Basically double up. Yeah, that's the easiest way I can think of, to be honest. So that's Pierce. I swear I'm okay. Beep. Slash. Years Blanto Energy and Shock. Oh my god, why does this end up in such a mess? Come here. Whoops. Does that take care of it? Kinda. Oh. Whoops! I forgot about these. Slash, pierce, blunt, energy, shock. Slash, pierce, blunt, energy, shock. Perfect. Okay. Will this work? Probably not. There. Save the right thing. Okay, that did actually work. Why are these in the middle of these? These should not be here, they should be here. 50 picks, 150 picks. Okay. CSS center vertically. Must be this, right? That might not work. We'll see. Oh, it does the whole thing. Whoops! And, I meant for the content to be centered inside the box, not the element itself. Ooh. Heard about that war, actually. Sorry, I'm not catching up on chat at the moment. I'm sort of distracted with code. Could that possibly work? Well, it's obviously going to be styled in the same way as... These two gonna have to be doubled. And we're gonna change the name to block lethality box. No. There. Lethality info box. No. What the hell happened here? Which one is which? Block lethality box is the one with the names, and then we have the lethality info box, which is that one. Okay, so the lethality info box is going to have the same CSS as the stat block info. Okay. So this. No. As this. That's the lethality info box, right? Yes. This music stressed me out. Can you please play something else? The block lethality box is going to have the other. Perfect. Now, if I only could center this in the element, that would be nice. I guess. I don't think that's gonna work, but I'm going to try anyway because I'm an idiot. We're gonna use that. I highly doubt that's gonna work. I was correct, that did nothing. What if I steal this entire thing? Still doubt it. Yeah, okay. That was all I needed to know. No, wait. I, of course, also have to copy this to the sheet. I'm so stupid sometimes. Shit. That doesn't look right. That looks very wrong. So we're gonna take that away because that was a bad idea. Let's not do that. Please be back to the way you were. Have a good one, Isong. See ya later. Actually works even if you zoom. But what if you zoom in a lot? It all breaks fantastically. But yeah, if you zoom in too much, this does break. But at that point, you kinda have yourself to blame for using such a small screen. Okay, all right. It looks okay. Let's make another item. Oh, actually, I just realized something. The skill isn't even listed. I have forgotten about the skill, which we must have
in the info box, and it's going to be at the very top.
Also, that should not have that. Type. Oh, that's up there. Okay, so that's too far up. We have to go down to here. And here, we're going to have one of these boxes. No, let's take one of these boxes and just copy that. If a variable's skill, I seem to believe that's just skill, straight up skill. Yes. If variable skill is not empty, skill required. Thank you. Skill. That should be at the top there. 1.5 hand weapons. That's a problem. One that is solvable with CSS, me believes. There we go. But this is worst case scenario, so... Oh no. How does solve this? That's gonna... Yeah. You're gonna do a stupid test again. I do that. What happens? Does it stay on its own row then? Probably not. Yeah, that doesn't do anything. Unless... Display inline block. That kind of works, except for the huge margin that suddenly showed up. I don't think that's gonna change anything, to be honest. My god, can you just cooperate with me? Thank you. I just want these for now. I could solve it by limiting the number of... I could... Just rename this. Bastard weapons. That would solve everything for me, because it does that. Oh. This is a problem. Okay, fine. This needs to be 43, and this needs to be 50, 60, no, 55? What? Oh, I thought I removed that. Sorry. That is going to have to do. Okay, fine. If we take this to 100 pixels instead, what happens then? That is too short. Throw this away. Also too small. 140. Yes, thank you. I was like, eh. That will have to do. Okay, now that this is not broken anymore, have I forgotten anything? I need to look at the boilerplate. The boilerplate is at the bottom. No, where's the boilerplate? Oh, it's here. All right. What have we? Name, type, skill, availability, trader, price. Trade group, quality, weight, description, slash, pierce, energy, shock, parry, shield protect. Shield protect we not have. Shield protect we must add. We will add shield protect. It's gonna be right after parry. So this is going to be shield protect, shield block, shield protect. Next, reach, range, mag, auto, accuracy, rough, charge, armor areas. We got the all. Do not save. Zoop. There we go. Now, we make a new item. We just copy an old item. It's not going to be a longsword. It's going to be... Every time I hear the word parry, I think of Perry the Platypus. I see. I'm not familiar with this. So this is going to be some form of armor, like padded mail, for instance. Padded mail. Type, it's soft armor. Skill, not required. Availability, common. Trader, bazaar or armorsmith. B, C21. Trade group, 11. Quality, normal, weight, 20 pounds. Perry! Exactly. That's a terrible description. /5433. 5433. Can we not have all the stressful music today? The hell playlist, give me a break. Thank you. Armor areas. This is chest, abdomen, upper body. Tags. Soft armor. Armor. Male. Gambeson. Medieval. All right. Copy this and put that it in here. Block. Reach should probably not be listed on armor. We need to fix reach. If variables reach, if variables type matches, we're just gonna steal that old thing there. Where would that be? What if the armor mlemlem's a target? Ew, don't remind me. Twig reg x does not match. That's usually the one. No. Fine. Let's do this instead then. Weapon. I did not like mlemlem. There we go. I just realized something. And that's going to show up right now. Because we're gonna make another item and this is going to break my everything. Scheiße. Create another. Sheets list. Energy blade. That only does energy damage, though. Yeah, I guess. I guess you're never gonna have an item that does slash, blah, 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 and energy. So this might work. We make a ranged energy weapon, laser pistol. Skill. That's gonna be light energy weapons. Light. Oh. Energy. Please search. Light energy weapons. Block link. Rare. Trader. Black market. Price of too much. I'm just gonna make up some numbers right now. Weight 1.2 kilos. Pew pew kachu. Slash no energy. 4. Shock 1. Mag. Actually, don't I have this somewhere? Let me have a look. Energy weapons. Oh my god, that broke everything. Laser pistol. Mag 4. Oh, 50. It actually weighs 1.2. Yes, I know it's broken right now. I'm gonna fix it. Hold on. It's just because I'm looking at something right now. Does it actually do shock damage? Yes, it has to. I'm gonna set it at 1 for now. Range is 5, 10, 30, 70. Mag is 50. Oh, right. And the charge is 4. Now, let's close this and fix World Anvil that went to hide for some reason. Hello? Come back. Thank you. Ranged weapon? Ranged. Laser, energy, modern, cyberpunk, pistol, handgun. And then we take this block and put it in here. And have a look. What I was afraid of. This I'm gonna parse later. There's a risk of that. Range actually is going to be turned into one of these things. It's going to be just listed eventually. But not right now. Because I don't have the time. Why does it say reach? Oh. Melee weapon. I'm just gonna parse this. Or should I just make them boxes? Question you people who use CD10. Should this be how you enter the ranges of ranged weapons? Or should I have 4 boxes, one for close, normal, long, and max? What would be easiest for you? Just enter it like this, or enter it in 4 boxes? Because that will determine how I code this. let me know. One box, okay. So I'll make a parser that just parses through that and puts that in boxes like these, or more like these. It's gonna be like close, normal, long, max, and then the values below. Below. Okay. But I need to figure this out. Because I'm gonna have the same problem with ammunition and, yeah, ammunition and arrows, because ammunition only does one type of damage. So they're also just gonna have two. The question is if I'm just gonna make a separate renderer for when it's ammunition or energy weapons that just renders to two boxes instead. That'll probably lead to less breakage. Actually, no. I can do this. Or can I? I think I can solve this in a smart way that makes this not absolutely break. Because there are also shock weapons that just do shock damage, and that's just one box. I kinda need to... make some if statements here. Eventually. Not gonna do that right now. Because it's usable right now, but eventually I need to account for that. Then we really only need to add an automatic weapon, I guess. Automatic. Nope. Okay, ranged. Firearm. Yeah, let's do that one. Create a new Maka TMP. TACMP. This is an automatic ranged weapon, and it requires submachinagannus, which I'm going to have to look up, of course. Submash. Copy. Lock link. Availability. Ra. Trader. Black market. Actually, I could just copy this. Regulated weapons dealers. I swear you just said coffee. Coffee? Copy? Yeah, okay, fair. Close enough. Black market. price is 6,800 credits. Quality normal weight 2.9 kilos. No description for this one, really? Apparently not. Okay, fine.
Blahness.
Alright, it doesn't do damage. I just remembered, it doesn't do damage. It has a magazine of 25. Ranges though, it is 10, 30, 60, 120. 10, 30, 1, no, 60, 120. Mag 25. Accuracy, I don't remember, but I believe it's pretty low. It's like minus 4 or something. Roth is 3, 6. Weapon, ranged weapon, ranged submachine gun, modern. Blip. Yeah, it has no damage things. Because to work with that one, I feel. What did I do now? What did I break? Why did that just explode on me? Did you break? What happened? What happened? That was strange. Not sure why that happened. I wish you could have blocks within blocks. Because then I could have the ranged or the 9mm ammo that this uses. Actually, I think it's 10mm. Anyway, the ammunition this uses in here. But I'm gonna need to figure that one out eventually. And this. Somehow. I'm gonna go with projectile weapon and automatic weapon. And then we're gonna reload this. Yes. This is an automatic weapon. That works. Okay. Could you request blockception? I think that would be possible to break too much things if you did that. But I will consider it. I mean, this thing, this range thing, is still going to be in a block here. So there is going to be something in this block. Just, you know, not the damage, because in CD10, it's not the weapon that does damage, it's the ammunition you use. So, it's going to be there. Except for laser pistols, which have energy, and, you know, it depends on how much of a blast you're firing. So the laser pistol is actually the thing doing damage. Sort of. It's the laser beam, but it depends on the charge, etc. Actually, hey, wait. This shouldn't have damage values either. Because it depends on the size of the blast. So. This shouldn't have damage values either. Come to think of it, actually.
So, there you go.
Laser pistol.
This should not be doing damage. Blep. Blep.
But I do need an ammunition part for this. So if it is a weapon, type, right after type, we're gonna have at 75, we're gonna have an item. So, ammunition. One-liner string. What kind of ammunition the weapon uses, be it 9mm, 10mm, 5.56mm, arrows, or bolts. Laser. And then I'm gonna have to go into this one and change this to 75 because it's gonna be near the top. And then we're gonna add this to the top skill. Yeah, it's just gonna be here at the top. So we'll add it right here. And info row needs to go away because we don't need it. Which means we also... Shit. There, that should go away.
Ew, variable skill. This is going to be variables ammunition.
Ammo, ammunition. Variables ammunition. There we go.
Switch to display mode.
Blep. And then we go to here and reload the damn thing. Because now we have ammunition, which is going to be laser. Save. And then we can go to the Markatakimb and select ammunition here, which is going to be a block a link to, I do believe that uses 9mm, I'm not sure, but I think so. Ammunition 9mm JHP. You can make a block link, but I think it should probably just be text. But we'll see. We'll retry both.
Blep.
Now we have ammunition here. Laser. And we have ammunition. 9mm JHP. That works. Anyway, I have been babbling on for way too long, so it is time for me to hop on over to transition, please. Do here. And
it is time for me to end my stream and send you over to, I think I saw Hefe go live.
We're going to raid Hefe. The Hef man. Who is playing games. Either way, I need to go eat and then probably rest. It's been fun today. We've gotten a lot of stuff, a lot of work done on this block, which is great. It's not done yet. It is not far from done, but it's not done yet. We have more stuff to do. And probably some more styling to do. But either way, it has been a good day, and I thank you for hanging around. I will be back on Thursday, same time as always. Do not forget to drop a follow if you haven't already. Consider becoming a patron and support this great game. And join the Discord. You hear me? Okay, good. Now go and raid the Hef, invade the cult, invade with the cult. Anyway, you know what to do. I'm gonna go lie down. Have a good one. And I forgot to switch to the thing. I'm great. Have a good one. Bye.